In this video, we're going to explore what an APU is and what it might bring to the future of computing. Let's jump into it. Building a desktop PC is something beautiful. Picking each component according to your needs, putting it all together after sometimes years of research, and then finally seeing it posed for the first time is just magical. Since the end of the 90s, the way we build computers hasn't changed much. Anyone who's built a PC already knows a lucky 7. Get a nice case, a motherboard, a CPU and a graphics card, those RAM sticks, a power supply and a storage solution, and you're good to go. Those 7 components have evolved exponentially, changing the way we work and the way we game in a shape we never imagined. They have brought VR to our homes, and now we can do tasks like video editing or 3D modeling with standard builds. We moved from hard drives to SSDs. Now there are mainstream CPUs with 16 cores, and graphics cards became insanely powerful, but also very expensive. At a time when technology is moving towards mobility and power efficiency, is there still room for desktop PCs? Contrary to what most people think, in 2018, global PC sales experienced a resurgence. Desktops remain a solid fixture in the commercial and educational sectors. In addition, they have seen a global revenue increase of 54% annually for gaming. The global market of this particular type of gaming computer is expected to grow from 15.1 million shipments to 19 million, and as of 2017, it accounts for 28% of the total gaming market. So, desktop PCs are alive and kicking, and they're still the only type of computer that offers upgradability. But how can this amazing technology get to even more people? Well, that's simple, with affordability. Unfortunately, building a capable gaming or working station PC was always seen as a luxury. One of the main problems was the cost of the video card, also known as GPU. Nvidia has been the market leader in the top tier and discrete GPU market for 20 years now, and rightly so. The problem is that their top tier cards are basically for that infamous 1% of the population. Their current mainstream top of the line 2080 Ti was released at a whopping 1,200 euros, so yeah, forget about that. How about the discrete video cards then? Well, AMD offers options like the RX 580, which starts at 150 euros, and that's great, but if we add the cost of all other components, we end up with a base of 500 euros. And that's without considering the mouse, keyboard, monitor, or speakers. People watching this in the US or Europe will be like,
"Hey, that's pretty good."
But for most of the world, it's actually not. So what could bring prices down and make PCs affordable for the vast majority of people while still bringing enough computing power to game or do content creation? The answer to that might be APUs. APU stands for Accelerated Processing Unit, and it's a microprocessor designed by the semiconductor giant AMD to act as a CPU and a GPU on a single integrated circuit. For the first time after decades, we see the first big leap into system integration for mainstream desktop PCs. Yet, APUs are not new. If you had a PS4 or an Xbox One, you've already used one. And today, in 2020, AMD APUs will power the new generation consoles coming out later this year, the PS5 and the Xbox Series X. And yes, that is a terrible name. AMD started to work on APUs in 2006 when they acquired ATI, the graphics chipset manufacturer. The project was named Fusion, and the first generation desktop and laptop APU, codenamed Yano, was announced at CES in 2011 and released shortly after. Only 2 years later, Sony and Microsoft introduced semi-custom AMD APUs in their consoles. Okay, so APUs can definitely game, but will they have enough power to replace video cards on the desktop market? All signs point to yes. Nowadays, a GPU that can game in 4K at more than 30 frames per second starts at 400 euros, while new generation consoles will deliver the same performance for around the same money. We can clearly see a huge disruption coming. AMD is now the market leader since the release of Ryzen CPUs and APUs in 2017, ending a decade of crippling quad-core technology by Intel and bringing the prices down through fierce competition. The new AMD 7nm microarchitecture called Zen 2 has made a significant breakthrough in CPU power in July 2019 with the introduction of the Ryzen 3000 line. Still, no 7nm APU has been released yet. Their previous APUs, codenamed Raven Ridge and Picasso, were based on 14 nanometers and 12 nanometers respectively, and had 4 cores and 8 threads on their top tier line, which tell us that we are on the edge of a big jump in performance, knowing that the new 7 nanometer APUs coming soon will have 8 cores and 16 threads, and that AMD's new GPU microarchitecture called RDNA still hasn't been implemented on current APUs, which will help boost graphics even further. The future looks promising indeed. As a matter of fact, we can already find videos on YouTube of gaming capable builds for 300 euros using the Ryzen 2400G or 3400G APUs, which are the ones still based on 14 and 12 nanometers. There are very interesting things which might happen if we get the performance we think we will from these APUs. First of all is the power consumption. One of the goals of AMD is to maximize power efficiency, which transforms into less energy use and less waste heat. Second is the natural form factor reduction by not having graphics cards at all. The smallest mainstream motherboard is ITX, which is indeed quite tiny, just 170mm by 170mm. But if we don't need a GPU, then the PCIe slot on even the smallest board would become obsolete. This means that we can get even smaller and cheaper boards that will be more portable, and of course, no GPU means less fans, less noise, and less power draw. And third is the drop in the overall cost of a system. As we stated in the beginning, the biggest challenge for desktop PCs was to become more affordable and reach most of the world. The system integration of the two most important components of a build might be a great start. A smaller, cheaper, and upgradable gaming or working PC might be here sooner than we think. I hope you enjoyed the video. The fact is, we don't know for sure if APUs will bring a major change into the way we build computers, but the fact that they might is already exciting enough. And there's still a big gap in performance in between a discrete GPU and an APU system, but I'm really looking forward to check out the new upcoming line of 8-core 16-thread chips. Thanks for watching, until next time.